Hi, good morning, everybody. I am Sarah Smith. I'm a horticulturalist here at Rogers Gardens, and today we're doing our Thursday edition live stream where I talk to you about the plant of the week. So I know I have a lot of different things here today. I'm going to do it a little bit different this day. Normally, I just introduce you to the plant, tell you a little bit about the plant, but this is the easiest plant, so there's really not a lot to tell you about. So I kind of wanted to show you some ideas on how to use this plant, how to combo it up, how to plant it in pots or put it in the ground. So that's what all this is here. But today's plant of the week, this is Kufia. So there's a lot of different types of Kufia. This one they call the firecracker plant, but the flower does come in a lot of different sorts of shapes. But this one is a really, really great one for hummingbirds. So that's what we've been doing this whole entire summer. I've been showing you different plants that are really great for attracting hummingbirds because we are doing the summer of hummingbirds here at Rogers Gardens. We've been comboing all different kinds of plants all together in one area that attract the hummingbirds. We put a lot of different feeders out and stuff. So if you haven't been here yet, please come in because it is just swarming here with hummingbirds and monarch butterflies. The monarch butterflies, we have all the native milkweed. We have a lot planted in our display garden. There's tons and tons of monarch caterpillars everywhere, so it's really fun every day to come in and check out all the new ones and see all the older ones that are getting ready to start their chrysalis. So it's been a really, really fun summer here with so much activity. But this week's plant is the Kufia. So I have two different kinds of Kufia here to show you, and like I said, there's tons of different kinds of Kufia. But the hummingbirds really, really love this one. And when we talk about the different kinds of plants that attract hummingbirds, I'm sure you're starting to see a theme. Lots of these little tubular flowers, they love that. They're a great nectar plant for them. They really you know, attracted to all the oranges and reds, but they really kind of will come to sort of any kind of color if they have options. You'll really see them. They kind of bounce around from plant to plant to plant, and they kind of make almost like a little trail or like a little set rhythm of what they go to within the day, because they wait a bit, so then that one will fill back up with nectar and then they come back to that later in the day. So it's really kind of cool to see them out in the garden doing their thing. But the Kufia plant is really, really a great one for them. It's a really nice one once you get it established. It doesn't require a lot of water. It would prefer full sun, but it can handle some partial shade depending on where you live. The more sun you have though, the happier and bushier and more flower you're going to have. Does great in the ground, does great in a container as well. Has flowers on it practically year round, which is really, really cool. A good cutting back in the winter time to keep it nice and bushy is really great, but it's not something that necessarily needs to be deadheaded. Some of them can stay on the smaller side, some can stay on the larger side, so always check your tag. Everything will have tags and tell you how big it gets. We have really great posters up that shows you all the different types of hummingbird attracting plants that we're featuring here at Rogers. We have these beautiful stickers on everything that will tell you if it's a hummingbird attracting plant or not. But there's a lot of things that attract hummingbirds that aren't even really traditional hummingbird attracting plants. So what I wanted to show you is some really cool planting options for this. We do sell them in these nice, so if you're not wanting to come in and plant up your own thing, or maybe you feel like you don't have a green thumb, but you really want to start trying to attract all the hummingbirds, and the bees love this, and the butterflies as well. We have them done in these nice big pots, just ready to go. So you just grab it, take it home, set it down by the front of your door or wherever you have a nice spot for full sun. Boom, done, which is really, really nice and easy. I really love this one. This is Vermillionaire. I love the color on this guy. Here we have another one. So you can see there's different varieties, and this one's a little bit more compact too, as well. This is Hummingbird Lunch. How cute is that name? It's so cute. But this is a smaller flower, a little bit of a lighter color, but I just love this orange color. I think it's so pretty, and it really combines up really well with other plants. So I wanted to kind to show you some things that I was looking at. This makes a great filler plant for inside a pot. It can kind of hang over a little bit to a degree too, so it's a really great one to push towards the edge of a container. So I have this nice black container here. I love comboing bright colors with a solid color, preferably a dark colored pot. You can really kind of get away with anything, but I think it really makes the oranges and reds pop when you put it next to a black. So I was grabbing some stuff and I was going for stuff that would still all attract hummingbirds. So lantana, this is a great one for the hummingbirds. The butterflies love this one as well. This is a nice trailer. This is not like the lantana that you're used to that gets really woody and big and crazy and out of control. This is a nice little compact lantana right here. This one's called Hot Blood Red. And these colors together, I mean, come on, they're like made for each other, right? And then I grabbed this Kniphofia. So when we're planting, we want something that has, when we're doing a combo pot, you want something that has like a tall kind of linear shape, a really showy flower. Look how beautiful that is. The hummingbirds absolutely go crazy for this as well. So just these three plants together, so easy, so pretty. They combo up so well. I don't know if I can get them all in the pots with their containers. No, I don't think I can, but I'm gonna show you what this combination looks like. Look at these three plants together. Beautiful. And then the hummingbirds will go nuts for this pot. They would absolutely love this. Great colors, the butterflies as well with this. Full sun, doesn't require a lot of water. These are all fairly drought tolerant plants. And then the other thing that I think a lot of people don't realize, and you really see it here if you come in, and again, because these are all plants that don't require a lot of water, hummingbirds love the flowers on all the echeverias, all the aloes. So once this flowers and it's getting ready, this has a really pretty tubular flower too, and these colors together, so good, right? So pretty. These would combo really well on the ground or in a container. I love adding to a little bit of that limey to make that orange pop, that coloration so pretty together. Once this flowers too, the hummingbirds really like this as well. So it would be a really, really fun one to do and make a cute little pretty pot with all these different, we have so many different options. I even got a salvia, this little red salvia. Of course, the hummingbirds go nuts for this as well. So all of these would attract all those great pollinators, all the hummingbirds, all the butterflies, all the bees as well. So this would be a really fun one to combo up. It just makes such a great filler. In the garden too, it can get fairly big over time. So keeping it tip pruned just to keep the size kind of controllable. But if you want to allow it to kind of ramble in and take up a nice space, this will absolutely do that for you. And the color is just fantastic. Again, full sun, low water, doesn't really require a lot of fertilizer. You can use just a regular rose and flower fertilizer on there. But that's kind of it. It's the simplest, easiest plant. So if you're just kind of dipping your toe into the plant world and you want to do something that's going to attract the pollinators, this is a really, really good starter plant for you. And you don't even have to get as crazy as making a whole container with a bunch of different stuff. Come in, grab one of these pots, already done, already filled out. There's actually three plants in this one, so when you really look at it, you can see there's three plants in there. So it's a really, really great deal for these pots as well. And I love this hummingbird lunch. It's just so cute, and that name. Seriously, come on. It's so adorable. So it's a great, great, great starter plant. We're doing these live streams every Tuesday and Thursday. The Thursdays is always the hummingbird plant of the week, so I'm always introducing something new to you. So make sure you always tune in for that. On Tuesdays, you see the lovely Suzanne. She's usually talking to you about a different care topic, of things to do in the garden, what to do at this time of year, how to color, do color pots. So she does a little more in-depth. So if you really want to know how to do something like this, she's going to show you all that kind of great stuff as well. And then we are back to doing our in-person seminars, which is really, really great. We had one last Saturday. It was really exciting. It was all about hummingbird gardening. We had a really fantastic turnout. It was so much fun to actually interact with everybody, to see all of your faces and see you all in person. We gave out a 10% coupon to everybody who showed up as well. We had all kinds of really fun, interesting plants there. And it was so fun to hear everybody's stories about their hummingbirds. They're just such a charming, kind of endearing little creature that everybody kind of has their special little stories about it. So it was really, really fun to do that. And we're going to be doing them. So there's going to be two every single month. Go on to our website. You go into the Learning Center and you can see all the different seminars that we have coming up. We're even having a really awesome one that is going to be in our small workshop. It is one that's not a free one. It's one that's $10. $5 gets donated to the Sea and Sage Audubon Society. And it's all going to be about photographing hummingbirds and how to do that. So they're super fast. So he's going to show you some really great tricks for that. But it's a really, really fun one. And even if you're just getting into it, or you're not even necessarily interested in going out and being a professional bird photographer, just all his photos and stuff are just so fantastic. So make sure you check that out as well. I think there's still some room in that, but that one will fill up because it's in a limited area. And then of course we are live right now. So if you have any questions, put those questions down below. I can answer them for you. If you're just tuning in now and you're just like, oh my gosh, I missed a bunch of this, we will post this and you can watch the whole entire thing and ask any other questions you have at the end, and we'll get back to you with those questions as well. Do we have any questions right now?
Seems like we do not. We have a lot of comments that they love the color combination.
I know, isn't this just like so hot and gorgeous and like screams summer? It's just so pretty. And when I was walking through and I was getting prepped this morning, I thought, you know, there's not a lot to tell you about Kufia. It's so easy. So as I was going through, the first thing that really got my attention was getting in all these Niphofia. So this plant here is called Niphofia, and the colors together are like meant for each other, right? And then of course, the Lantana, and Lantana is so pretty. And the Lantana, again, is great for all the butterflies as well. I always tell everybody, if you want to know what attracts butterflies, because people always, you know, it's kind of easy to know what's going to attract a hummingbird. It's going to be a tubular flower, probably in the red range. Doesn't have to be, but they definitely do go for the red. But with the Lantana, I always tell people, anything that looks like a miniature helicopter landing pad. So think about the butterflies as being the helicopter. This absolutely looks like that. It even has a little bullseye in the middle. Doesn't need that necessarily, but things like yarrow, they really like that too. The butterfly bush is more of a kind of cone flower, but it's a big cluster of little miniature flowers when you really look at it. So the hummingbird, or sorry, the butterflies can land on it and then have some place to hold on to and grip onto it very well. So they love this stuff, and so do the hummingbirds. So it's kind of nice. You get a 3-for-1 basically, because all the pollinators are attracted to this. But yeah, when we, if you walk into the nursery and you go into the main area where we have the whole setup for all the hummingbirds, we will have that Kufia on that very front main table, and they just go crazy for it. It's so fun to watch them, and they fight over it and they chase each other away, and just it's just so amazing to walk through. Yesterday there was tons of activity. I know I say that every single time, but certain days really shock me. I was working in that area for most of the day, and it was like I was almost dodging hummingbirds and butterflies for part of the day because they're just so aggressive with the plants. It's so funny. They're the chihuahuas of the bird world is what we call them here. So little and vicious, which is kind of fun, but they're very, very sweet to watch. It's so fun to watch them. Yeah, but yeah, please come on in. Check out all the really great stuff we have going on. We have really beautiful, beautiful hummingbird feeders. We have our own hummingbird food. We have it down in our area where we sell all those hummingbird feeders, and it's different than just sugar and water. It is a full balanced nectar that really, really kind of duplicates what they are getting from the flower. So if you can't do a lot of flowers and you really focus on feeders, you don't want to just give them all the sucrose. They need all the fructose. They need all the glucose as well. So this one is a really balanced one specifically to mimic all the requirements the hummingbirds need, because it's not just all sugars for those guys. So make sure you check that out. It's really great. You don't have to mix it with hot water. Warm water works totally fine. It's very concentrate, so you get a really good amount out of there as well. So, and then if you come in and you have any questions later, please let me know. Do we have anything?
We have we do have one.
Yeah, sure.
Could you just rename all the plants?
Sure, absolutely. Yeah. So this is the Kufia. These guys here, and here's just a smaller one as well. So this is also the the millionaire. So that's what's in this one. There's three plants in this big pot, but this is just a singular one. So Kufia is the plant of the week. And then I grabbed some other things to go with it. So I grabbed specifically the Nyphophia because this just came in and it's just so pretty and combo so well. And when you're doing a mixed pot, what we always say is you want your thriller, your filler, and your spiller. So this is definitely your thriller. It's so pretty. Usually you want something that's linear, and then you want something that spills over, and you want something that fills up a pot. So those are the three things you're looking for. It's just like flower arranging, basically, right? So your vertical, your filler as well. So Nyphophia, isn't that beautiful? And it comes in a lot of different kind of colors. This is Paco Sunset. So it definitely gives you that sunset vibe too with that color, right? And then the Lantana. I thought these all together were just so pretty. So Lantana. Lantana will also work as a spiller and a filler as well. So Lantana also comes in a lot of different colors. This one's called Hot Blood Red. And then I grabbed some succulents too, because they really do. The hummingbirds love the succulents, especially when they're flowering. So this is an echeveria. They also like aloes. They like ioniums. Those all will get a nice flower. On this one, it's Red Baron. So this actually does give me the name. But this gets a nice little tiny flower on it. That's a tubular shaped flower that the hummingbirds really go for. And I love this kind of red, deep color, especially because this Kufia, if you look at the stems of the Kufia and you look at the coloration of the succulent, very similar. So it's always really nice to kind of recall a color from one plant to another. That really kind of helps your eye move through an arranged pot. I just love that together. So they really kind of mimic that coloration. And again, the hummingbirds will go for this absolutely. And this one's Crassula. And why I picked the Crassula is I wanted to kind of pick up a little like limey brightness to kind of brighten up the pot, but it has that nice, really pretty red edge to this one. And this one's Jade Sunset. So obviously we've got the summery sunset kind of vibe going on, which is really, really cool. And a really, really great, easy plant. All of these are fairly low water requirements once you get them nice and established. And once you're noticing some new growth on them, don't require a lot of water. Love the heat. We'll be absolutely happy through all of the summer and into the fall. And then of course I grabbed salvia. So this is Salvia greggii. There's a lot of different kinds of salvias. Really great hummingbird attractor, great in a container as well, and especially if you're filling it up with something else. But so pretty together, such great color combos, just really fun, really, really easy. And like I said, if you're just getting into the world of plants and you want something different and you want to get all those hummingbirds into your yard, this is a really great starter plant. If it's something, I know this is kind of a different Kufia that most of us are used to. Most of us are used to this false heather Kufia. So this is a very different type of Kufia. Doesn't even really necessarily look all that the same, but they are the same. And sometimes they call them bat face Kufia. When you look at these, it's kind of funny. You're not going to be able to see this on screen, but it has two little ears. It almost looks like a cat to me. It's so cute. So there are ones that are more bat facey than others. Sometimes they call them cigar plants too, because they're that long tube that's so red and hot looking. But so cute, so easy, so fun, so simple, so hummingbird perfect. Hummingbird lunch, I mean, come on. It's just so cute. So anyways, thank you so much for tuning in. I really love doing these live streams. I love seeing you in person even more. So if you can make it to our in-person seminars, please come in and say hi to Suzanne and I. It's been really, really fun. We will stream those as a live stream. For the meantime, we're going to continue to do that. So we will post that later onto our Facebook and onto our Instagram page. We also post these to our YouTube page. If you haven't checked out our YouTube page, go subscribe. There is so much amazing content. We're filming new stuff all the time. I know Suzanne just filmed a new one that will be posted later. So I think it's all about plumerias. So there's always great new content. You can go back into all the old content as well. It's really fun. So you can see all different kinds of people here talk about all the things that they're passionate, that they're really interested in. It's always fun to watch someone talk about things they're passionate about. So it's a really great experience. Also, make sure you sign up for our mailing list. If you go to our website, you can sign up for our mailing list there. You will be the first one to know about all the fun exclusive events and seminars and all the kinds of things that we're doing here all the time. You'll know about all the deals and specials as well. And it's just a really great way to stay on top of what's going on here so you don't miss out on anything, because a lot of the things that we do here, especially our exclusive plants or plants of the week, sell out really fast. So you will get to know about all those things before anybody else. So thank you so much for for tuning in. If you have any questions that you think about later, please put them down below. We will answer those for you. Make sure that if you have anybody in your life that you know is really into hummingbirds and all that, make sure that you tag them down below so they know about what's going on. And be well and be safe and happy gardening. Bye. Thank you.